लेखक के लफ्ज वो जब उन्हें अपने जहन अनुभव और आशाओं के रंगों में डुबोकर खुला छोड़ता है तो परिंदों की तरह कौन सा लफ्ज किस आसमान से कैसी खुशबू उड़ा ले आए अपने आप में एक उपहार है और ये उपहार हर बार लेखक को जितना हैरान करता है उतना ही मोहता भी है नए लफ्ज बुनने के लिए। लेखक कवि कहानीकार और हाँ पत्रकार जेरी पिंटो इस मोह को मानते हैं अपनी किस्मत और एक आशीर्वाद भी। A snatch of a conversation between us.
Welcome to the show, Jerry.
Thank you so much, and I'm so happy to be here in Chandigarh. It's so green, so beautiful, yeah. So clean. It's obvious that Chandigarhis love their city and take good care of it.
Yeah, I hope we continue to.
And I hope so too, because it's a lovely city and it's an opportunity that every other city would give its eye teeth for, simply because you had a chance to invent this city right from the start.
You yourself are a total Mumbaiker, right?
I see myself as a person who explores. I see myself as an Aflatoon. I come to Chandigarh and I would love to be a Chandigarhi. But will you take me? Will you give me a home here? You know, I believe that that Mumbai is my karma bhumi. So people ask me, all your books seem to be about Mumbai. And I say, they're not about Mumbai. They're about me. And because I happen to live in Mumbai and I know the place well, you can only write what you know about.
Yeah, and the city is inside you, I think.
Shahar bahar hai, lekin andar bhi hai.
Exactly. You're here to launch your book, M and the Big Home.
Yes, indeed.
Is this a completely autobiographical account?
Jab main Helen ke baare mein likh raha tha, उस वक्त लोगों ने कभी नहीं पूछा कि ये ऑटोबायोग्राफी है कि नहीं, लेकिन वो भी ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल था।
एक a bit of you always seeps in.
Yes,
but maybe this has a lot more of you because
yeah, actually you see, जब लीला जी के बारे में लिख रहा था, लीला नायडू के बारे में लिख रहा था, at that time too, it was because I met her when I was 21, and she was so beautiful, so graceful, so elegant, कि I thought this is like a gift. This beauty is like a gift to everybody. When she walks into a room, the room lights up.
Yeah, you've written this in the foreword.
And I think, yeah, that was what made me want to help her write her autobiography. So this book is about the lives of four people living in a small flat. Now, Chandigarh wale, aap nahi jante ki 400 feet mein rehke kya kya जुल्म होते हैं, इन सेंस आई मीन यू नो यू डू एक मिनट भी नहीं है जहां यू आर प्राइवेट, यू नो पीपल इन दिस सिटी इन दिल्ली दे हैव 3 बेडरूम्स, दे हैव बिग हाउसेस, बाहर आंगन है, गार्डन है, जामुन के पेड़ हैं, उस जामुन के पेड़ के नीचे एक इट्स एज इफ देयर सो मच स्पेस. बॉम्बे इज स्मॉल, इट्स अ टाइनी लिटिल finger of land poking into the sea, and then 13 million people are scrambling to find a foothold and to find some space. So you can have a huge flat also, lekin wo flat ke samne ek big building hoga, aur wo building mein those people are looking at you, you are looking at them. Now in such a situation, if there is someone who has a mental problem, how does that family cope? How does the family cope with issues of growing up, yeah, of loving one another, of trying to provide some sense of security to each other? That's what my book is about.
Did you have anybody in your family who?
Yes, my mother had bipolar affective disorder, much like the character of M in the book. Much of what I have written is based on what happened in the family, but no one ever writes, even if you are writing clear autobiography, you can't tell everything because it would bore people.
In this world, you know, in which people are like so fiercely protective about their personal lives, their stories, you know, what makes a writer like you, what makes an individual like you want to tell his story, number one, and then what is the need and what does it do to you?
Whenever I talk to a writer and he says ki bhai hota nahi hai humse, book band padi hai, कहानी लिखी नहीं जाती, आई से थिंक अबाउट वन थिंग, देर इज नो नीड फॉर एनी मोर बुक्स इन द वर्ल्ड, देर आर इनफ बुक्स. सो द ओनली रीजन टू राइट अ बुक इज बिकॉज दिस इज वॉट यू नीड टू डू, नॉट वॉन्ट टू डू, यू नीड टू डू इट. सो इफ यू नीड टू डू इट, देन यू विल डू इट समहाउ. It will may take you 20 years, it may take you 2 months.
Yeah.
And for me, this was a need. I felt that this book was something I had to write. And once I had written it, once it had gone out into the world, to har din ek telephone call, har din ek SMS, har din ek email. My brother was like this. Meri maa aisi thi. I had not expected that this book would become a talking point for mental health. But it has become that.
And it is reassuring for many, maybe.
And many, for maybe many people it is, are Jerry Pinto bol raha hai ki this is semi-autobiographical. Iske saath hua hai. So maybe it's not such a problem. Maybe it's just something simple like having diabetes. Ki, you know, what happens in diabetes? Your pancreas mein jo islets of Langerhans hai, wo kaam nahi karte. What happens when you have a mental problem? Your neurons, your nerves, your brain cells don't do their work. And the result may be a little more dramatic than diabetes. Maybe you start thinking God is talking to you. Maybe you start thinking people are all conspiring to kill you or whatever. Maybe that is a little more dramatic. But asal mein kya ho raha hai? It is a disease.
Yeah. You're ill. It's a very biological thing.
It's a biological thing. And there are some psychological things, some things that have hurt you, some things that are in your past that need to be talked about. We need to start talking. We need to start airing these things. In any situation, if you throw open the windows, if sunlight comes in, if air comes in, if words go out, things get better.
Yeah.
To talk is human. And to talk about mental illness is something that we all need to do.
When you are dealing with somebody who's suffering from such a disorder, you know, you have to be probably make an extra conscious effort to retain your sanity. Because even your sanity can get challenged all the time, and it means that you bottle up a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
So maybe, you know, this is a little of an eruption in its own way. Your words have been some sort of a volcanic eruption in their own way.
You know, it's a very interesting question. I'm thinking about my answer even as I'm saying it. Jo main bol raha hu, main soch raha hu, and so it's going to be half formed.
Yeah.
Because I haven't been asked this question before. You're very right. In almost all that we talk about, or jo bhi hum baat karte hain mental ill health ke baare mein, we talk about the sufferer. We do not talk about
the people with them.
Yeah, the people who love them, the people who have to look after them. What us pe kya guzarti hai? Shayad they need a little support. Maybe they need a little understanding. They're very easy. It's very easy to blame them, to say, ki, why don't you look after this person better? But it is difficult because you love the person and the person loves you too. But the way they are demonstrating it does not fit in with the way the world thinks love should be demonstrated.
Yeah.
So you have to fight this battle not only with the person you love, but with yourself and with the outside world, which is pointing a finger at you, pointing a finger at her, pointing a finger at your whole family. So you begin to think, why should I talk about this? Why should I tell you? Because you will not understand. You have not been here. So don't preach.
Yeah.
Don't tell us what to do. We will manage quite well. That is it's the natural.
There's a lot of anger also.
You know, you feel helpless rage. You feel, mere saath kyun hua?
Yeah.
Mere parivar mein kyun? And you mean, perhaps God is asking, aapke parivar mein kyun nahi?
Did you find this some sort of a karmic understanding, and did you find some sort of a perspective? Have you come to terms with it, first of all?
See, you know, ek baat hai. People say, likh lo, sab khatm ho jayega. Catharsis होगा, सब आ जाएगा बाहर, पन्ने पे होगा, छप जाएगा, खत. Doesn't happen that way. But what does happen is, it moves a little inside your heart to a place where it's a little easier to bear. And I think that healing is something that happens because you talk. Does that calm come easily? No. Does it come naturally? No. I know many people who carry anger throughout their lives. Who die angry. You don't know what it's like until
you're in it. Yeah.
You're in it. And each person's love is so special and specific to that person.
Yeah.
Angrezi mein ek hi shabd hai love. I love my mother, I love my boyfriend, and I love lassi. Wahi shabd. Lekin ye teen love ek jaise nahi hai. There are different kinds of love. One comes from the heart, one comes from the stomach, one comes from history. But it's only one word that we have to use it for all of this. How do you deal with that? So, ye words jo hai, khatarnak cheez hote hain. They're very, very different emotions, because there are very, very different people involved in each of these situations. And that is something that we have to realize. Kahani ka jo, ki jo shakti hai, is because each story looks at two or three or four completely different people. And wo jo ek shabd hai love, wo badal jata hai har ek kahani mein.
हम शब्दों की बात कर रहे हैं. यू नो यू यू वॉन्डर्ड अराउंड अ लॉट. आई मीन यू यू टॉट मैथमेटिक्स.
क्या पापड़ बेले हम.
आपने लॉ पढ़ा और आप फ्रीलांस जर्नलिस्ट रहे एंड यू हैव डन अ लॉट ऑफ वर्क इन दैट ऑफ कोर्स एंड यू हैव रिटन बुक्स. यू राइट पोएट्री. योर फर्स्ट पोएट्री कंपाइलेशन वाज अज़ाइलम. आई मीन आई एम नॉट सरप्राइज्ड व्हाई इट वाज कॉल्ड अज़ाइलम, बट do you remember the point where you know words kind of started tapping at you and you felt that okay, you know, this is probably my haven in some way?
You don't choose these things.
Yeah,
I have always said I would like to be a musician.
Yeah,
if you, when you sit down at the piano or at your musical instrument and you begin to play, the person sitting in front of you can be from New Zealand or from Africa or from Kerala. They understand your music. Words are different. You have to know the language. So musician seems so effortless. Baat alag hai ki main ga nahi sakta hu, baja nahi sakta hu. I'm tone deaf also at a certain level. So I don't think you choose. You have a certain set of skills and then you begin to discover what those skills are.
You know, in during your journey with birds, ek aspect jo aapki aapne jo bhi likha hai uska ye hai ki you've been closely associated with the film industry in some way. You've written a book.
Nahi, bahar se, not bahar inside. Se.
Yeah, but you've been an outsider, a very active one.
Yeah, I'm a gadfly. I just keep jumping about and poking around. Mm-hmm. See, I believe that ye jo film industry, I don't think people have quite understood how important Bollywood is. Other countries have been completely, their film industries have been wiped out by Hollywood. We've still got a valid film industry. Now, why is that? It's because all this while we told stories that mattered to people. Abhi hum angrezi mein film banane lage. No one says, main tujhse behad mohabbat karti hun. They say, I love you, Rahul. You know, I love you, Rahul has taken over from, I think mohabbat, no one can write probably in the film industry now. If anything, they'll say, main pyar karti hun tujhse. You know, it's like we've come down, we're dumbing down everything. And I don't think that's a very good idea.
Achai, film industry, you know, what is it like? And how different is it from our life, you know?
Think about it. Bombay ko Maya Nagri kehlate hai na. Maya Nagri mein jo Maya Nagri hai, wo Bollywood hai. So, ye double Maya Nagri hai. So, it is a very dangerous place.
Yeah.
You can slip into the illusion
get lost
of believing.
So easily.
And of believing that this is reality. And once you start believing this is reality, then everything follows. Plastic surgery follows. Underworld connection follows. Murder follows, casting couch follows, because you have forgotten that this is an illusion within an illusion.
Have you met a lot of people who live in this illusion?
I think, you know, I've met a lot of people who don't even know that there is an illusion around them. And that is frightening. That is truly frightening.
Very frightening.
Yeah. But it's also a glamorous place. And that glamour is seductive to all of us.
Yeah.
It's just that now we allow ourselves to talk about it. Khuliyam. Before that we used to say, oh no, time pass ke liye. You know, you could only buy a film magazine when you were getting on a train long distance and you would read Stardust or Filmfare on the train. Fascination has just gone mainstream.